Hello and welcome to Inside SAIS. Let's start with the first issue, that is Rani Lakshmibai. It was in news recently. The Prime Minister paid tributes to Rani Lakshmibai on her 191st birth anniversary. She was one of the leading figures of the 1857 War of Independence. She was born on 19th November 1828 in Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh. Rani Lakshmibai was one of the brave warriors of India's struggle for independence. In 1853, when the Maharaja of Jhansi died, the East India Company took advantage of the situation and applied the doctrine of loves to annex Jhansi. And guys, in comment box mention who was the Maharaja of Jhansi at the time. Lakshmibai fought bravely against the British and gave a tough fight to Sir Hugh Rose, who was the military commander at the time. So to save her empire from annexation, she died fighting on the battlefield on June 17, 1858. When the Indian National Army started its first female unit in 1943, it was named after the valiant Queen of Jhansi. Doctrine of Loves. So it was an annexation policy followed widely by Lord Dalhousie when he was India's Governor General from 1848 to 1856. In comment box, mention who was the first Governor General of India and who was the first Viceroy of India. According to this, any princely state that was under the direct or indirect control of the East India Company, where the ruler did not have a legal male heir, would be annexed by the company. As per this, any adopted son of the Indian ruler could not be proclaimed as a heir of the kingdom. By applying the doctrine of loves, Dalhousie annexed the states of, first state was Satara and last state is Nagpur, please remind it. Satara in 1848, then Jaitapur and Sambalpur in 1849, Baghat in 1850, Udaipur in 1852, Jhansi in 1853 and Nagpur in 1854. These seven are very, very important. Please remember it. So the next issue is space internet. Recently, the world's leading private company in space technology, that is SpaceX, has launched the Starlink network in lower Earth orbit, that is LEO, aimed at providing low-cost, reliable space-based internet services to the world. In comment box mention in which country the SpaceX is located. Currently, fiber optic cables or wireless networks through mobile towers provide internet services. It can be noted that the idea of space internet system is not new. It is being used through geostationary satellite for selective users. Starlinks. Let's discuss something about the Starlink. The Starlink is a SpaceX project to build a broadband network with a cluster of orbiting spacecraft that would eventually number thousands. The Starlink satellites carry Hall thrusters which use electricity and krypton gas. This is very, very important, and always remember Starlink electricity and krypton gas to generate an impulse to maneuver in orbit, maintain altitude, and guide the spacecraft back into the atmosphere at the end of their mission. So the Starlink network is one of the several ongoing efforts to start beaming data signals from the space. So the next issue is Swachh Sarvekshan Gramin Report. That is Gramin Awards 2019. It was organized by Ministry of Jal Shakti, and it marks the occasion of World Toilet Day, which is observed every year in November 19. The Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation, that is DDWS, under the Ministry of Jal Shakti, had commissioned Swachh Sarvekshan Gramin 2019 SSG 2019 through an independent survey agency. It aimed to develop rankings of all districts of India on the basis of quantitative and qualitative sanitation, that is Swachhta parameters. So rankings, first top three states, one is Tamil Nadu, second is Haryana, Third is Gujarat. This is very important. Top three districts are Peddapalli of Telangana, Faridabad of Haryana, Rewari of Haryana. Guys, note it down somewhere so that you can revise it. It is very important. It may be factual, but it can be asked. State with maximum citizen participation is Uttar Pradesh. Corporates felicitated Cement Manufacturers Association CMA, Hindustan Unilever Limited, and Amul for their contribution under the Swachhta Hi Seva campaign 2019 towards effective plastic waste management. Guys, in comment box, which four districts of India of different states has been declared as plastic district? Mean they will create plastic manufacturing will be there. So please write in comment box. How could social influence, one question is there, how could social influence and persuasion contribute to the success of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan? And it was asked in 2016 remains. So the next issue is National Institute for Sowa Rigpa. So the Union Cabinet has approved setting up of National Institute of Sowa Rigpa at Leh, that is Union Territory of Ladakh. It will be autonomous national institute under the Ministry of Ayush with the mandate to undertake interdisciplinary education and research programs in the Sowa Rigpa in collaboration with national and international institutes. NISR will act as an apex institute for Sowa Rigpa system. It will develop synergy among the existing Sowa Rigpa institutions, namely Central University of Tibetan Studies, Varanasi, and Central Institute of Buddhist Studies, which is located in Leh. So the existing Sowa Rigpa institution under the Ministry of Culture, it will also help to revive Sowa Rigpa in the Indian subcontinent and also link the traditional wisdom of Sowa Rigpa with modern science tools and technology. Guys, in comment box, mention this in Ayush, one system is Unani system of medicine. From which area this medicine was borrowed, please mention in comment box. Sowa Rigpa, the science of healing, is a traditional system of medicine practiced in the Himalayan belt of India. It originated in Tibet and popularly practiced in countries namely India, Nepal, Bhutan, Mongolia, and Russia. Yuthuk Yonten Gunpo from Tibet is believed to be the father of Sowa Rigpa. I am repeating it. Yuthuk Yonten Gunpo from Tibet is believed to be the father of Sowa Rigpa. In India, it is widely practiced in Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, West Bengal's Darjeeling, Himachal Pradesh, and the Union Territory of Ladakh. The majority of the theory and practice of Sowa Rigpa is similar to Ayurveda. So let's move to the next issue, that is Amnesty International. According to Amnesty International, the protest over rising fuel prices and subsequent government crackdown have cost many people their lives across Iran. The US economic sanction on Iran and the rise of gasoline prices in the country have resulted in a collapse of Iranian currency, that is rial. Amnesty International is a London-based non-governmental organization founded in 1961. The organization aims to create a world where every person enjoys all the human rights enshrined in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and other international human rights standards. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted in 1948. It recognized the fundamental human rights universally for the first time. It also conducts research, generates actions to prevent grave abuses of human rights, and demands justice for those whose rights have been violated. The organization was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1977 for its defense of human dignity against torture, and the United Nations Prize in the field of human rights in 1978. Guys, in comment box, who was the Nobel Prize winner for peace in 2019? A question was asked in 2004. Describe the role of Amnesty International in securing human rights. So the next issue is ICAO. The recent incidents of Pakistan's denial of use of its airspace to India has been taken up by Indian government to the International Civil Aviation Organization, that is ICAO. India sought overflight clearance from Pakistan for the Prime Minister's aircraft to go to Saudi Arabia on 28th October 2019. Pakistan cited alleged human rights violations in Jammu and Kashmir to deny the request. International Civil Aviation Organization, and it was established in 1944, and it is a United Nations specialized agency which laid the foundation for the standards and procedures for peaceful global air navigation. Its one of the objectives is to foster the planning and development of the international air transport so as to ensure the safety and orderly growth of international civil aviation throughout the world. India is among its 193 members, and it is very, very important. And it is headquartered in Montreal, Canada. So in comment box, guys, mention Montreal Protocol is related to what? So a question was asked in 2014 prelims, which of the following kingdoms were associated with the life of Buddha? So option 1 is Avanti, option 2 is Gandhara, option 3 is Kosala, option 4 is Magadha. Avanti and Gandhara are not associated with Buddhism, only Kosala and Magadha are associated. So option C is the right option. Though Gandhara art and Mathura art we have studied, but Gandhara art is there, but Buddha, life of Buddha, it is not associated with it. So let's move to the next question. Amnesty International is an agency of the United Nations help refugee of civil wars. Second option is a global human rights movement. Third option, a non-governmental voluntary organization to help very poor people. For last is an international intergovernmental agency to cater to medical emergencies in war ravaged regions. The right option is answer B, a global human rights movement. So that's it, guys. Have a nice day. Let's do the questions.